So what happened was I panicked and scrambled and went up to the front of the church, or the back of the church, I should say, to get in a line that had actually disappeared. And I could see that none of the children were around anymore, and my husband was gone. And so whereas it was everybody who wasn't wearing a robe. But I happened to be there still. And so did everybody who wore robes. You know, the people who, I guess, were participating in the service or who were monk-like, had positions of solitude where you sit and, I don't know, whatever it is that these people do, the monks or the nuns or whatever they do. I looked around and everybody had disappeared, and the people who were wearing robes had started to panic. And they were like, well, where did the church go? Now, I've said this many times, I don't care. And I sincerely don't care about the rapture, or don't really. I mean, I've listened to it because I entertain the idea of both sides of the story. I'm fascinated by how you can have preachers who are very well known, who are knowledgeable, who are theologians, and how all of them can come on different sides of this. Now, this might be because, if you really consider, if you can stand in a church, just as they say, you could the church could disappear, and you won't disappear with it. Maybe it is given to them in the spirit that they know they won't be here at a certain time. And maybe it's given to some people in the spirit for sure that they know they will be here. Because I remember as I looked around and saw that everybody else in the church was gone, the Holy Spirit confirmed you weren't supposed to leave. And you're supposed to be here. And it wasn't like a message of condemnation. It felt like reassuring, it felt comforting, and it felt like you still have things you need to do. There's still more work for you that needs to be done. And whereas everybody else in the room started panicking, their panic caused me to want to panic emotionally, but the spirit kept saying, no, that's a spirit of fear, you're not supposed to feel that. This is now. You don't understand. You still have a mission. And sometimes the spirit will say things like that to you and not tell you what the mission is. Sometimes it needs you to stumble upon it. It'll give you the clues. It'll give you moments of, epiphanies. And I was supposed to just stay still and do what I've always been doing, praying, reading the book, and keep battling from below. And that's what I was called to do. Now, it's one of those things where everything around you looks like it's crumbling, and you're like, but am I supposed to be here during this? But there are so many times in history, like during the Holocaust, like during all kinds of different times in history where Christians weren't rescued. Christians had to see things out until their final end. And I just expect that. And again, this really could be speaking to my expectation. But the fact that it happened so fast and I wasn't expecting, you know, sometimes in a dream you can kind of feel what's going to happen next. This was weird. It was like I couldn't have predicted it. I couldn't feel that was going to happen next. And I remember looking around and seeing this big empty room that was packed with people. And the children were gone. And everybody without a robe was gone. And I remember being the only one without a robe who was still there. And I couldn't believe it. This really could just be about me, and something about a message to me. But I just remember feeling this split mind, you know, how on one side when I looked one way, I felt like I wasn't a wife. I was, you know, a servant to the Lord, completely a servant to the Lord, who actually had the outer appearance of that. I remember sitting next to somebody who was dressed in kind of like what the priests wear. And, you know, I could actually rub elbows with this person and feel very comfortable as a sister in Christ with that person. And it's like a time in my past when I, in my early 20s, before I was married. It's the same, my mind was the same way, exactly what I was then. And then when I looked the other way, all of a sudden I felt this, you know, wifely way. You know, I felt like I couldn't get close enough to my husband, like I couldn't hold his hand close enough, I couldn't be close enough. And the more strange the circus of the front of the church got, the closer I wanted to get to my husband. But anyway, that's the dream. This is Linda of Christ is King Forever. May God be with you.